My name is Tom Peters. I'm the chief engineer in the Wireless Telecommunications Bureau. We started with 1G. We skipped 0, went back to 1G. And that was really analog voice. I went to 2G. 2G really represented the digitization of the cellular signal. But it was still primarily voice. And it was still primarily what we call circuit switched, meaning whenever you have a connection from your phone to the base station, you have a specific circuit, and you have that circuit whether you're using that bandwidth or not. Whether you're transmitting, if you're talking to someone but neither one of you is saying anything, that circuit is still open and you're still using those network resources. We went to 3G, and 3G offered some packetization of the resources. Speeds got faster. When we go to 4G, now what we're getting into is a full migration, because 3G sort of represented a half migration. You still had some circuits switched in 3G, and you still have some legacy architectures that make it more expensive for the operator. When you go to 4G, what you're getting to is sort of the internet model, where everything is IP based. Everything is packet-based, even voice. Newer technologies that are able to use the network resources more efficiently and give more people more bandwidth, more speed, more of the time. You know, a station transmitting on channel 23 in Washington, you can't use channel 23 again until you're in a city that's a certain distance away, such that you won't get the interference between the two. You also have some adjacent channel interference, meaning, my example is channel 23. It's not good to use channel 22 or 24 close by either. So you end up with a lot of what we call white space. That means unused television stations. The trick is not interfering with the broadcast television. There are a couple of ways that could be done, and it's really by putting intelligence in the radio. So one way to do it is this thing called cognitive radio, where the radio is smart enough to say, hey, I can hear channel 23, and I hear it at a signal level that's above a certain threshold. I'm smart enough to know that I can't transmit on channel 23 because of that. And I'll find another frequency that is below this threshold, and I'll transmit on that one instead. So a second option is to use GPS and a database of locations. And in that scenario, before transmitting, the device will say, okay, I get my coordinates from the GPS, I know where I am, here's my database of frequencies that I'm allowed to transmit on from this location.